Hello and welcome to the video tutorial on how to define operating modes and check results in EcoStruxure Power Design Ecodial. In this demonstration, you will view the procedures to define operating conditions, surge arrestor connection, run calculation and check results, choose type of warnings, check project discrimination, check RCD discrimination, and check cascading results. Let's begin by understanding how to define the operating conditions in a network. The operating conditions feature helps you to create and manage the electrical installation operating constraints. The operating modes feature helps you to get the final design by considering the worst case of all the operating modes created by the user. When using normal and backup sources, if one of the sources is not defined at the initial stage, then you need to create an operating mode to define the source. To define a new operating mode, click the Operating Mode drop-down and select Management of Operating Modes. Duplicate the existing operating mode and name it. Provide any additional information about the new operating mode in the optional comment section. Click Close. Make sure to keep Default Operating Mode, or Master Operating Mode, or Primary Operating Mode, or Normal Operating Mode for MV Source and LV Source only. Also, whenever Genset is there in the network. In case you select Generator as Master Operating Mode, then you will not be able to connect the capacitor banks and power factor compensation is not possible. For the newly added operating mode, define the connected source and feeders by opening and closing circuit breakers, fuses, and switches. Next, let's view the procedure to define a surge arrestor connection. Before connecting a surge arrestor to the network, from the Project Parameters tab, enable the surge arrestor connection. Select the overvoltage risk category of the surge arrestor. Now that the surge arrestor connection is enabled, access the Design and Sizing tab and connect a surge arrestor to the network. Next, calculate the network. The application has automatically suggested a solution. Next, let's view the procedure to run calculation and check results. After successful creation of the network and providing all the necessary inputs, the next step is to calculate the network. After calculation, the alarms window provides information on the installation sizing. When you click on any error or alert, the respective circuit will be highlighted in the diagram and its solutions details open in the Properties tab. Select the Detail tab to view the calculation notes for the circuits. Select the Curve tab to view the tripping curves, discrimination status, and protection settings. Next, let's view the procedure to choose the type of warnings. After calculation of the project, a list of messages will appear in the alarm window. In the alarm window, all types of messages will appear, including errors, sizing, and warning. You can hide or unhide the warnings related to the discrimination and cascading. However, the warnings related to sizing will always be visible in the alarm window. As per the requirement, you can keep cascading or discrimination warning along with sizing warning. Next, let's view the procedure to check project discrimination. Select the protection device for which curve needs to be seen. Select the Curves tab. The discrimination status is displayed on the top left of the curve area. Use the sliders to adjust the settings if necessary. The discrimination status is automatically updated, considering the new settings. The setting status is locked to retain them for the next calculation. By clicking on the lock, it is possible to revert back to the settings proposed by the application. The same can be seen on the network as well by accessing the More Info tab. Next, let's view the procedure to check the residual current device discrimination. Select the RCD protection device for which curve needs to be seen. Ensure that the RCD is there in the upstream device as well. Select the Curves tab. Select the curve for residual current protection. Use the sliders to adjust the settings if necessary. The discrimination status is automatically updated considering the new settings. The setting status is locked to retain them for the next calculation. Click on the lock to revert back to the settings proposed by the application. Next, let's view the procedure to check the cascading results. Select the protection device for which cascading results needs to be seen. In the Properties tab and Solution section, you can see the Reinforced Braking Capacity, which indicates that the cascading is applied. Use the More Info tab to view the cascading results on the network. This concludes the video on how to define operating modes and check results. In this video, we saw how to define operating conditions, surge arrestor connection, run calculation and check results, choose type of warnings, check project discrimination, check RCD discrimination, and check cascading results.